That's right, it's a rewritten, updated, and upgraded remake of one of our older videos. We're George Romero in the History of Coffee.
Oh, God!
We're talking about coffee. We get the word from this in Dutch, which came from this in Ottoman Turkish, which in turn came from this in Arabic. Now, the Arabic may have come from this, which means to lack hunger, or this, which means energy or power. That's right, you can't mispronounce it if you don't have to say it. Or it's from the Kaffa Kingdom of Ethiopia, where coffee may or may not have originated from. But where exactly did coffee originate from? Well, there's a story about an Ethiopian shepherd. I said Ethiopian. There you go. Who noticed that his goats would become rather energetic after eating from a particular plant around the year 850. It might be true, we don't know, but you know, that's how a lot of history works. As far as documented evidence, we're going to Yemen in the mid-15th century, where Ahmed al-Ghaffar wrote that the coffee berries or cherries would be opened, the seeds removed from inside, and roasted pretty much the same way we still do it today. The drink was used by Sufi Muslims to stay awake at night as well as to suppress their appetites during fasts. And Yemen pretty much had a monopoly on coffee exporting, especially from the city of Mocha. Yeah, that's where that comes from. They kept this monopoly by only shipping out the baked or roasted coffee, never the actual raw beans that could be used to grow a plant. It's rather smart of them, really. In fact, the first coffee beans to make it out of Arabia were smuggled into India in the beard of Baba Budan. In the 16th century, and a Dutchman named Peter van der Broek managed to steal several plants from a Yemeni plantation around 1616, which didn't really take back to the Netherlands, but after they shipped them off to Java, they took off rather well. And a funny thing about coffee, as its use spread, coffee shops began to open up right and left, and these shops became the centers of discussion and the spreading of knowledge. Hell, the famous Lloyd's of London was originally founded as a coffee shop. At the same time as coffee made its way into Europe, it was supposedly introduced by the Turks at the Battle of Mohacs, by the way. Many in the clergy saw it as a bitter invention of Satan and called for it to be banned. It caused such an uproar that Pope Clement VIII was asked to step in and make an official ruling. And after trying the drink, he gave it the official papal seal of approval. It was also banned by several Muslim clerics, but these were also overturned. Much like Raymond, everybody loves coffee. The Dutch kept several plants in the national greenhouse, and eventually one of these plants was gifted by the mayor of Amsterdam to French King Louis XIV around 1713. And the king loved it, and he had it planted in his royal garden. Then, around 1720 or so, Gabriel de Clux obtained a seedling from this plant and traveled with it to the New World, more specifically Martinique. And it's believed that every coffee plant currently in North or South America, including the Caribbean, comes from this seedling. If you're drinking coffee right now in America, it could probably be traced back to this one single seedling. Now, there are reports that the French had already begun growing coffee in present-day Haiti as far back as 1714, but we're not sure on that source. We do know that the terrible conditions on coffee plantations was one of the main reasons for the Haitian Revolution that began in 1791 and ended in 1804. But how did it get to Brazil? Well, the French were not very willing to part with any of the plants, and the Portuguese were chomping at the bit to get in on that sweet, sweet mocha money. So they sent Francisco Paleta to speak with the governor of French Guiana, which is still a French territory, by the way, and they still refused. But Francisco was able to seduce the governor's wife, and when he left, she gave him a bouquet of flowers that contained several seeds hidden inside. At least that's the story. And from that, today, Brazil is the world's largest producer of coffee, having held that title for about 150 years. About a third of the world's coffee comes from Brazil, and all it took was a little seduction and millions of native and African slaves. Also, many of you have probably noticed that tea is big in the UK, but on this side of the pond, coffee is king. This goes back to the Boston Tea Party, as well as embargoes against tea that were placed on America by the British during both the American Revolution and the War of 1812. But, I mean, come on now, the real reason why Americans drink coffee instead of tea is because the British drink tea, Americans drink coffee. By the way, one last little thing here, the most expensive coffee in the world is Kopi Luwak, and it's rather special in its creation. See, the cherries are eaten by a species of civet, it's like a cross between a cat and a lemur. And these civets crap out the seeds, which are then collected, roasted, and sold for between $35 and $100 per cup. Yeah, depending on quality, it'll cost you between $100 and $600 for a pound of it. Unfortunately, it's expensive for its novelty rather than its quality. Yeah, I guess you could say it tastes like crap.